The last point we're going to analyze in our titration curve is what is the pH after the addition of 26.00 milliliters of sodium hydroxide. So here we're going to be past the endpoint, and we have our acetic acid plus sodium hydroxide giving sodium acetate plus water. So we have our initial concentrations, the amount we add, the neutralization step, and then our end amounts. So initially we have 2.5 millimoles of acetic acid and zero sodium hydroxide. Here we're going to add 2.6 millimoles of sodium hydroxide. Okay, in our neutralization step, we need to neutralize 2.5 millimoles of acetic acid. That means 2.5 millimoles of the base are going to be added. And at the end, we have zero acetic acid and 0.1 millimoles of hydroxide ion. In the process, 2.5 millimoles of sodium acetate were produced, and at the end point we have 2.5 millimoles of our sodium acetate here. So when we look at this and we have a particular salt, this is going to have a minimal effect or a minimal influence on the pH. Here we have OH minus ions. This is going to have a large influence on the pH. So once we are beyond the endpoint, our pH is dictated by our excess OH minus ions. Okay, so for our sodium hydroxide, we're going to have 0.1 millimoles in excess, and we added 26.00 milliliters of sodium hydroxide to 25.00 milliliters of acetic acid. So this has a total volume of 51.00 milliliters. This is going to give us 1.96 times 10 to the minus 3 molar, which is equal to the concentration of OH minus ions in excess. So we can then calculate the pOH, which is 2.71, and then if we do 14 minus that, that will give us the pH, which is 11.29. So when we're looking at these particular cases, once we go past the endpoint, we have to figure out how much hydroxide ion is in excess, and once we determine that, we can divide by the total volume. That gives us the concentration of OH minus ions. We can take the negative log of that to get the pOH, and then do 14 minus the pOH to get the pH, which happens to be 11.29 in this case. So in the next video, we'll analyze all the pHs that we did along the way to show what the titration curve for this weak acid, strong base titration will be.